Hello everyone! In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make this simple cartoon logo in Photoshop. After following this tutorial, you will create your own cartoon effect PSD file. And with that file, you will be able to recreate a cartoon logo out of any image within a few seconds. Please like the video, and let's get started. Step 1. Remove the background. First, let's start by making a new document. Set dimensions to any values above 2000 pixels with 300 resolution and RGB color mode. Then click Create. From File, place Embedded. Go and import the image you want to work with. Resize it as you want, then press Enter. Now pick the Quick Selection tool and make a selection around your object like that. Or if you have a newer version of Photoshop, just click on the Select Subject button to let Photoshop automatically make the selection for you. Adjust your selection like that, then click on the mask icon to hide the background. Now go and delete the background layer. Then right-click on the mask, choose Select and Mask. Pick the Refine Edge tool and start refining the hair like that. Make sure that the output is set to Layer Mask, then click OK. Now our image is fully isolated with the hair refined. Just select your layer and right-click and choose Convert to Smart Object. And with the Quick Selection tool, start selecting the head like that. Adjust your selection as much as you can. And with your layer selected, press Ctrl and J to take the selected head to a new layer. Select the full body layer and press Ctrl and T to make it smaller like that. Also select the head layer, adjust its size and rotation if you like. Now select both layers by holding the Ctrl key, then right-click and choose Convert to Smart Object. And now let's move on to the next step. Step 2. Create the cartoon effect. First, select your layer. Then go to Filter and choose the Liquify Filter. To get this updated version of Liquify Filter, you will need any Photoshop version above CC 2015.5. Please consider using an updated version of Photoshop, or just ignore this step if you want. Now go to the Face Aware Liquify section, and there you will find that Photoshop has automatically detected a face in our image. And there's a bunch of settings to control its facial features. Let's start with the eyes. Just move the sliders to control the eye settings like that. Also, increase the nose height and width to 100. And for the mouth, increase both upper and lower lip sizes to 100 and minus 100. And finally, for the face shape, you can set it to minus 50, minus 10, minus 100, and 15, or just use any other values you want. Let's see the before and after. That's great. Just click OK to submit, and let's continue. Now select your layer and press Ctrl and J to duplicate it. Hide the top layer and change the name of the bottom layer to Effect. Also change the name of the top layer to Tone. Select the Effect layer and let's apply the oil paint filter from here. If your oil paint filter is missing or doesn't work, please check this video description. Now change its values to 5, 3, 0.1 and 0. This will add an oil paint effect to your image like that. Click OK to submit. And now let's apply the surface blur filter. Just change radius to 20 pixels and threshold to 10. This filter will wipe away the skin texture and make it smooth like that. Now let's go to Filter and choose the Filter Gallery. Under the Artistic folder, choose the Poster Edges filter. Let's reset the values to see what's going on. First, change Posterization to 2 to divide the skin tone into different levels like that. Then, change Edge Intensity to 1 to add some black lines to your image edges like that. Finally, increase the edge thickness all the way to 10 to make the edges thicker. Click OK And let's decrease the opacity of this filter. Just double-click on this little icon to open the filter's blending options. Decrease the opacity to 35%, then click OK. As you can see, this will decrease the filter density to a very good level like that. Again, with your layer selected, go and reapply the oil paint filter. Leave all values as previous and just click OK. Finally, let's apply the unsharp mask filter from here. Change it to 150, 6, and 6. This will increase the overall sharpness and boost the details like that. Click OK. And before moving to the next step, let's talk about our today's sponsor. Skillshare is a huge online learning platform with thousands of premium classes for all creative and curious people. They have thousands of inspiring classes about graphic design, photography, illustration, filmmaking, freelancing, and much more. They offer almost 3,000 classes about Photoshop only. One class that I really like is the Photoshop Advanced Training Course from Daniel Scott. He has almost 14 hours of premium content for this class only. Unlike YouTube, Skillshare is 100% free of ads, so you can stay focused and follow wherever your creativity takes you. And for the first 1,000 people who join Skillshare from the link in my description, we'll get a 1-month free trial of Skillshare Premium membership. Join Skillshare to boost your creativity today. Now let's get back to our tutorial. First, select the tone layer and unhide it. Then go to Filter, Blur, and choose the Gaussian Blur filter. Set radius to 5 pixels and click OK. And with your layer selected, go and create an invert layer. Clip mask it from this little icon. Also, create a black and white layer and clip mask it. Now select the top layer, hold the Shift key, and select the tone layer to select all three layers. Press Ctrl and G to group them. Then name the group Tone Opacity. And finally change its blending mode to Overlay. This will add a HDR tone to your final effect, and you can control it by changing the group opacity from here. I usually keep it between 10 to 40%. Now let's move on to the next step. Step 3, make the cartoon logo. First, select the ellipse tool from here. And from the options panel, make sure that you're drawing a shape with any color fill and zero stroke. Then hold the Shift key and start drawing a circle like that. Select the circle layer and drag it below the effect layer. Double-click on the circle layer to open its layer style. Then go and add a 100-pixel white border from here. Then click OK. Now select the top two layers by holding the Ctrl key. Then press Ctrl and G to group them. Finally, hold the Ctrl key, then click on the circle layer's thumbnail to make a selection around it. Select the group and make a mask from your selection like that. Now select the mask itself. Then go and pick the brush tool. Change the foreground color to white. Then start painting over the mask to unhide the top parts like that. That's it. Now let's move on to the final step. Update the effect with a click. First, open the image you want to work with. Repeat the process in step 1 to remove the background and enlarge the head. Then open the effect layer smart object by double-clicking on its thumbnail like that. Drag your new isolated image and drop it inside the smart object like that. Press Ctrl and T to resize and reposition it. Hide the other image, then press Ctrl and S to update your effect. Get back to your main document. And here is the updated result. Please note that you can save this project as a PSD file for any future use from here. That's it for today. Please like the video and subscribe for more free tutorials. Thanks for watching.